Russia continues to pound eastern Ukraine with deadly strikes. At least two are dead and six people are injured in a rocket assault on a village market in the Kharkiv region. One person was also killed in Kherson following a strike on a residential area recently recaptured by Ukrainian forces. Kyiv says fierce battles are also taking place in the city of Bakhmut in the Donbas region.
Some 1,500 people are arrested as Brazilian security forces crack down on massive anti-government protests. Hundreds of soldiers and police were mobilized Monday to dismantle an improvised protest camp outside the army's headquarters in Brasilia. That camp was used as a base by thousands of supporters of former President Jair Bolsonaro as they ransacked the presidential palace, Congress building, and Supreme Court on Sunday. President Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva condemned what he's called acts of terrorism. Bolsonaro was narrowly defeated by Lula in the second round of the presidential election last October. Meanwhile, the former president is reportedly admitted to a hospital in Florida in the latest in a series of health problems stemming from a stabbing attack in 2018. And let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now with Bureau Chief TJ Manotok.
Good morning, Mike and Nikki. Here are the latest stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community.
I will well and faithfully discharge the duties upon.
We begin in Sacramento, California, where Rob Bonta has officially become the first Filipino-American elected to serve as Attorney General for the state of California. Bonta was historically appointed by Governor Gavin Newsom in 2020 when his predecessor, Javier Becerra, was called by President Joe Biden to serve in his cabinet as Secretary of Health and Human Services. In the elections last November, Bonta defeated Republican challenger Nathan Hochman by nearly 2 million votes.
It's been a busy 2 years because I believe now more than ever we need leaders in government and law enforcement who will build bridges with our communities. And today, the people of California have an attorney general who is doing just that.
Bonta previously served as an assembly member from Alameda, the highest position ever held by a Filipino-American in California until now.
No Filipino-American had ever served in our state legislature, and certainly not at the helm of the nation's largest state Department of Justice. But that is why the California dream is so potent.
Meanwhile, it's been 2 years of grief for Maya Minette's family. This past weekend in Chula Vista, California, the community held a memorial hike for the missing Phil-Am mother at a local trail that she would frequent.
It gives us joy. I know it's like an overwhelming feeling that we still have this much support from the community. We feel really blessed that a lot of people are supporting us after 2 years.
The 39-year-old mom went missing on January 7, 2021. Search efforts had gone on regularly as investigators kept close watch on the case. On November of 2021, Maya's husband Larry, father of their three children, was arrested and charged with her presumed murder. He has been in custody since and denies the allegations. The preliminary hearings for Larry will begin on Wednesday.
Closure is the number one thing that we're looking for. Finding her, getting answers, and then maybe we could move on.
And finally, Filipino-Canadians in Halifax, Nova Scotia enjoyed a night of laughter headlined by comedian Jobert Austria. Austria, who made a career for himself in Philippine show business, has been living in Canada since 2019. He entertained the crowd with his funny observations about life in Canada.
Merong mga Pinoy na pagdating ko rito sa basketball, tinanong ko kung Pilipino. Pilipino ba? Sabi niya, excuse me? Indian, hindi na nagtatagalog. Pagtingin ko, dalawang linggo pa lang pala rin.
Austria admitted he got cold feet from doing stand-up comedy several years before, but now feels more comfortable with his act.
Kailangan makuha mo lang isa. Makakuha ka lang ng isa, dalawang tao doon. Mahawa na yun eh. Kasi alam mo agad, ako alam ko agad pag sampa ko kung paano ko sila patatawanin. Mga ano, bigyan mo lang ako ng 3 minuto, alam ko na.
And those are the top stories amongst the Filipino community in North America. You can catch more of our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.